Hello grooming fans, it is Damjan from Man's Best Friend channel again, and today we have in my grooming salon this old and very matted Maltese. You can see he's matted, he's very matted, his ears are matted, behind his ears he's matted, his body is just very matted, and the tail is also matted. The owner was him short from head to tail, and that's probably the only thing I can do. I mean, I could maybe save the tail, but the owner was him short anyway. So his name is Batista, which is kind of interesting, funny. Okay, I'm going to find a place where he's not matted and start from 8.5 blades. He was here before, honestly I don't remember how he was. Was he aggressive or something? I mean, he is an old dog. He actually does not have a lot of teeth. So he cannot hurt me if he bites, but I want to avoid that, of course, but hopefully he'll be fine. Okay, his butt is very dirty. Okay. Hey boy. Have to be careful when the dog is this matted, you can easily hurt him while trying to dig under the mat with a clipper. Hey. Thank you. Okay, so I oiled and sprayed the blade so it's not warm. You see, these mats are just terrible. Okay, let me just take a picture of that. Yeah, this dog is super massive. Okay, I'm just taking a 10 blade, it is shorter and safer. When dog is this matted. Okay. Okay. Okay, so the blade is not formed. I want to do his face with a pen. It's safer, you can see how he's moving. Let's take this back. Hey. See how he's moving his leg every time. Oh, sorry. Every time I touch him. Okay, I'm taking the stand again. Because this here is very matted and I have to dig under the mat to take it off, and pen blade is better for that and safer because it is shorter. Thank you. Hey. Come on. Okay, so I did a lot. You can see that his ears are dirty, especially the ear shell. I can bathe that, but yeah, the ear canal is not that bad, which is great. Come on. Hey, hey. Don't pull. Okay, he has very long nails. Let me just finish around his butt. You can see it is quite dirty. Luckily this poop is old and dry. It's best way is to take it off like that and just put it in the trash can. Okay. I have to clip his nails now. See, they are, some are not that long. And that one, just look at that. I bet that he could not walk normally because of that nail. Okay, boy. Okay. I'm shaving his paw pads now. I mean, I'm shaving this here between the pads. Okay. It's easier for the owner to maintain a clean paws if you shave that. Hey! Like he has something there. Yeah, this is what was hurting him. Hope that you can see. Okay, that's enough for that paw. I don't want to irritate it. Okay. Okay. Okay, so I'm done with shaving him for the first time. I have to bait him now. That's what I'm going to do. Okay, okay. Take my girlfriend's apron with flowers. I have to soak these eye boogers so I can clean them with comb. This is a Chris Christensen shampoo hydrating blend. This is a concentrated and this is a diluted shampoo. Thank you. can see that his ear shell is very dirty. It's getting better, and don't worry, I make sure that I dry his ear canal after the bath. Yeah, it's actually very dirty. You can see his ear shells are. I'll do as much as I can now and I'll do the rest later. You can see how his ears got a little swollen and bruisey. It's because they were very matted. And a lot of you already know that when you shave a matted ear, because the mats can not stop the circulation completely, but mess up with the circulation. And when you take the mat off, the blood rushes to the places that it couldn't normally, to the places where the circulations were bad, and it can cause bruising and even bleeding. Please clean your dog's eye boogers. I want to shampoo him 2 times to make sure that he is clean. Thank you. Okay. Okay, and now I will apply the dog conditioner. It's also the Chris Christensen hydrating blend. It has a wonderful smell, it's not too strong. Okay, so the dog conditioner does not make foam like the shampoo, of course, and this conditioner is great. It is great, it leaves a great effect. The hair is easier to brush and it's very soft and smells nice, and it's also very, very easy to rinse. You just, when you're rinsing this dog conditioner, you feel like you haven't even put it on the dog. That's how great it is to rinse. Some conditioners can be greasy and very hard to rinse, and then you waste your time, and sometimes when the dog's hair is too long and you have a hard time rinsing the shampoo or the conditioner, it can last pretty long. I remember once I had a Newfoundland with a long hair, and I had a conditioner that was good. It leaved a good effect on the coat, but it was so hard to rinse, so hard. And as you can see, I don't have that professional bathtub that has a bar here, so the water can go under the bar. So, and when you use the water too much, you make like a little lake, and that lake was also full of that conditioner, and it was very, very hard for me to rinse that dog. So of course I don't use that conditioner anymore. So Chris Christensen is a brand. You can see the ears are swollen. Chris Christensen is the brand I highly recommend when it comes to cosmetics. I haven't tried their brushes and scissors, but I heard that they're awesome. Who knows? Okay, normally take a towel. Okay. And make a little dog burrito. Okay, I'm just going to leave him for like 2 minutes or five. Take a little break. Let the towel soak in the the water from his coat, and then I'll dry him. I'm not going to film the drying, it is kind of boring, and then I'll film the second shaving. Okay, so I finished drying him, and now I have to clean his ears. You can see that I already cleaned much, but I have to plug this here and clean his ear canal, make sure that it is dry. So this is an ear powder that is used for dog's ear plucking. It also makes the ear canal dry. It's good because this hair can get pretty slippery. And this powder makes it less slippery. Yeah, his hair, ear hair is very slippery and greasy. You have to do this because when there's no hair in the ear canal, the ear can breathe and it decreases the chances of an ear getting infected. And you have to pull it out. You cannot scissor it, make it shorter, you have to pull it from the ear canal. Hey. Okay, I'll have to use the hemostats. They are stuck in the paper with ethanol to be disinfected. Just want to make them a little bit warm. Because a metal cold object in dog's ears can be unpleasant. And dogs can react by pulling and moving instantly, and you don't want that. See, he is reacting. Hey. Okay. Okay. So I'm going to take cotton wool pad and the ear cleaner. Also want to make the ear dry, and you can see his ear is now pretty clean, right? Okay, let's take another one of these. Okay, well. So I'm going to start from his head. Also, actually, I'm going to start from his ears. Okay, and I want to do his face as much as I can. I mean, as much as he allows me to do. Okay. It is enough for the muzzle. I'm going to take maybe 8.5 to the top of the head. Okay, boy. Okay, so the hair is fine. Okay, I'm going to start with his tail. Okay. Okay, that's enough.
Thank you.
Okay, so the legs looks fine. Look fine. Okay, I'm going to take the fan blade for the armpits. Since he does not like me touching his front legs, Okay, I think that this is enough. He's old and I don't want to stress him anymore. He's not married anymore, which is the most important thing. And his ears are clean, his nails are not long anymore, so he can walk normally. And that's it. Thank you everyone for watching this video. Thank you for supporting me and motivating me to keep filming and filming. And that's it. I will definitely see you soon. Bye.